for cents a la Shmoop. Have you ever wanted a system you can use to judge just about anybody's performance?
Oh, whoa, yeah, babe!
You've probably heard percents mentioned during sporting events or seen them on your graded tests. Just about any statistic can be expressed with a percentage. When you express something as a percent, you are really determining how much per every hundred. The same way cents are a portion of a dollar, percents are a portion of 100%. Suppose you answered 24 out of 25 questions correctly on your test.
Yes, 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 yes!
First, we find out how many times 25 goes into 100. So we can multiply 25 by 4 to get our magical number of 100. Then we multiply 24 by 4, which equals 96. Congratulations, you got a 96% on your test.
You're a superstar!
Percents pop up just about anywhere you can imagine.
Hello!
For example, money matters are often expressed using percents.
Money, 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 money! Money!
Here's a hint. The percentages in credit card terms and conditions usually are not on your side. The best APRs come in small packages.
Peace, love, and happiness!
Percents are a key part of the language of economics, and sometimes just thinking in percents helps people to make good financial decisions. For example, even if an outfit is totally super cute, you probably shouldn't buy it if it costs more than 50% of your net worth.
How dare you!
If you're a sports fan, you're used to hearing percents all the time.
Jones is only shooting 27% from the field tonight!
Field goal and free throw accuracy in basketball, batting averages in baseball.
Strike! You're out! Again!
Passing completion rates in football are all expressed as percents. We hope your knowledge of percents has now been improved by at least 62%. In fact, you even look 62% smarter than when we started.
Great video, guys!